For this lesson, you need to open the sample file Sales Report 7 from your Sample Files folder. Next, you need to make sure you're in Page Layout view. You can use the buttons at the bottom right of the worksheet to move between Page Layout view and Normal view, but the view we want is Page Layout view. There's a slight problem with this worksheet. The first page is easy to understand, as it has a column header row to indicate which data is in each column, such as date, city, and company name. But the second page isn't so easy to understand, because the column header row is missing. I'd like to show the same column headers that are on the first page on every other page in the worksheet when I print the worksheet out. And we can do this by asking Excel to add column headings to each printed page. To do this, first make sure you can see the column headings on the first page of the printout, and then click Page Layout, and in the Page Setup group, Print Titles, and the Page Setup dialog appears with the Sheet tab selected. Notice that there's the option here to set Rows to Repeat at Top, so I'll click in the Rows to Repeat at Top text box, and then I'll click once anywhere in row 8. And you can see that the formula $8 colon $8 has been inserted into the box. This means every column in row 8. You could also type these in yourself if you wanted to. For example, to print rows 6 to 8 on each page, you'd enter 6 colon 8, or if you wanted to, $6 colon $8. The dollar signs denote an absolute reference. You learned all about absolute references in Lesson 312. So I'll now click the OK button, and then I'll print preview by clicking the File tab on the ribbon and Print in the left-hand menu bar. Let's now move through each page in the document using the Next Page button. And I can see that column headings are now shown on the first page, as they were before, but they're also now shown on all of the other pages on the printed page. And I'll now return to Page Layout view by clicking the Back button. Let's now address a different requirement. Sometimes it's difficult for the eye to track across printed lines. For this type of report, it's useful to print grid lines onto the printed page, in a similar way to the ones displayed on the worksheet. To show grid lines on the printout, I click Page Layout on the ribbon, and notice there's a Sheet Options group, and one of those options is Print Gridlines. I'll check the Print Gridlines checkbox now, and let's print preview the worksheet to see whether the gridlines are being printed. So I'll click File tab on the ribbon and Print from the left-hand bar. And you can see that gridlines are now being printed on the printed page. Let's now return to Page Layout view by clicking the Back button at the top left of the screen. And now let's address a different requirement. You may want to send a printed worksheet to a colleague and then discuss it on the telephone. It would be useful to be able to ask, "What do you think of the value in cell H11? This isn't possible because row and column headings are not normally shown on the printed page. To show row and column headings on the printed page, I click Page Layout on the ribbon, and in the Sheet Options group, you can see that there's an option to print headings. So I'll click the Print Headings checkbox, and once again print preview by clicking the File tab on the ribbon and Print in the left-hand bar. And I'll click the Zoom to Page button just to get a better look at the printout. And you can see that the column headers, A, B, C, D, etc., are being shown along the top of each column, and the row headers, the row numbers 6, 7, 8, 9, etc., are being shown to the left of each row on each printed page. I'll now return to Page Layout view by clicking the Back button. And now I'm going to switch off both the grid lines and column headers from the printout. To do that, I click Page Layout, and in Sheet Options, I'll clear the checkbox for Print Gridlines, and I'll clear the checkbox for Print Headings. All that remains for this lesson is to save your work, and I'm going to save with the new name Sales Report 8. And as usual, I'll save to the folder above my Sample Files folder. I click the Save button, and you've now completed Lesson 7.11. Add row and column data labels and grid lines to printed output.